Children, we'll continue the physiography of India. The third division of physiography is the Peninsula Plateau. Or the plateau region. Understand? In physiography of India, it is the division or 5 divisions are there in physiography. First one, we saw that the great northern mountain region. Understand? The Himalayas, the great Himalayas. And the second one is, the second division is the great Indian plains. The great Gangetic plain, Brahmaputra plain, Punjab and Haryana plain and Rajasthan plain we saw already. Now we are going to see the third division, that is the Peninsula Plateau. This Peninsula Plateau is a rocky region, hilly region. It is not the level land. It is a rocky region, we can say. Understand? This Peninsula Plateau is in the south of the Indian Great Plains. We'll see in the map then. I'll show. Can you see the board, children? Yes. Bay of Bengal in the east, Arabian Sea in the west, and the Indian Ocean in the south. Okay. So here the Himalayas in the north, Himalayas is here. Under that we have the Great Plains. And under the south of the Great Plains, we are having the Peninsula Plateau. Okay. Here in the Peninsula Plateau, the great Aravalli range is here. Aravalli. This is a mountain range. Okay. Aravalli range is here. And this Aravalli range is the northwestern boundary of this plateau, Peninsula Plateau. Northwestern boundary of the Peninsula Plateau is Aravalli range. Understand? And this Western Ghats is here. This is the Western Ghats mountain ranges. Okay. Western Ghats. These are the mountain, Western Ghats in the sense mountain range. Understand, children? And this is Eastern Ghats. This is called as Eastern Ghats. Here. This Western Ghats are continuous range. That's why I draw like this. Okay, continuous range is Western Ghats. And Eastern Ghats is discontinuous range. It is dissected by some rivers. We'll see it later. Okay, so the northwestern boundary of Peninsula Plateau is Aravalli range. The Western Ghats is the western border of the Peninsula Plateau. And the Eastern Ghats is the eastern boundary of the Peninsula Plateau. Okay, children. And next, now the highest peak in India, in the south, in the Deccan, this Peninsula Plateau is Anaimudi. Peak Anaimudi. Understand? Peak Anaimudi is the highest peak in this plateau region. This peak Anaimudi is in Anaimalai. Okay. In Anaimalai, we have the highest peak, that is called as peak Anaimudi. This is the highest peak. Here, next we are going to see about the shape of the Peninsula Plateau. Here, the Peninsula Plateau is somewhat triangular shape. The Peninsula Plateau is triangular shape. You just listen carefully. It's this triangular is western side. From western side to eastern side, it is somewhat slope. This is eastern side and this is western side. This is east and west. Okay, so this is slope. This Peninsula Plateau is somewhat slope to eastern side. Understand? This is very important. Then next we will come to the point. This river Narmada, it divides the, here is river Narmada. River Narmada. This river Narmada, it divides the Peninsula Plateau into two. This river Narmada divides India into two. That is the North India and the South India. Can you able to follow, children? Okay. Then next one, this peninsula plateau is divided into two. The peninsula plateau into divided into two. They are Central Highlands. Central. The peninsula plateau is divided into two. One is Central Highlands and another one is Deccan Plateau. The southern part is called as Deccan Plateau and the northern part, this is north. The northern part is called as Deccan Plateau and the southern part is called as Central Highlands and the southern part is called as Deccan Plateau. Understand? Now in Central Highlands what we are seeing, we will see now. Yeah, thus in the Central Highlands, the western side of the Central Highlands, there is a plateau that is called as Malwa Plateau. Malwa Plateau. Here is Malwa. Upper of River Narmada. Upper to this River Narmada, there is a plateau in the Central Highlands. That is Malwa Plateau in the western side. Malwa. Malwa Plateau. In the west. And in the eastern side, another plateau is there. It is called as Chota Nagpur Plateau. See all of you? Chota Nagpur Plateau. Another one, Chota Nagpur. This Chota Nagpur Plateau is full of minerals. This is in the western side and this is in the eastern side of Central Highlands. Can you able to follow, children? Listen carefully. Don't be confused. Listen carefully. Then only you can follow. In the Central Highlands, the western side of the Central Highlands, there is one plateau that is called as Malwa Plateau. And the eastern side, there is a plateau. That region is called as Chota Nagpur Plateau. This Chota Nagpur Plateau is full of minerals. So many industries are there in the Chota Nagpur Plateau. Like that, here is West Bengal, Orissa, Bihar. In these states and all, we can find many industries because of the minerals found in the Chota Nagpur Plateau. So these are all about the Central Highlands. We'll go on to Deccan Plateau. This Deccan Plateau is triangular in shape. I'll draw the side. This Deccan Plateau is triangular in shape, Arabia, Bengal, Arabian Sea and Indian Ocean. Here, this Deccan Plateau. This is Deccan. Understand? So, this Deccan Plateau is triangular in shape. There is two divisions in Deccan Plateau. They are the Western Ghats. Already we saw the Western Ghats and the Eastern Ghats. This is Western Ghats and this side Eastern Ghats. Have you understand, children? Okay. Here, the Western Ghats and the Eastern Ghats, they are the the western side of the margin of the Deccan Plateau is Western Ghats. The eastern side margin is Eastern Ghats. Understand? Here, it is triangular in shape. We saw that. And the Western Ghats, this is the continuous range. Understand? The Western Ghats, they are continuous range. The Deccan Plateau is divided into two. Western Ghats and the Eastern Ghats. In the distinguish between, they will ask you in the questions, distinguish between Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats. At the time you have to write, Western Ghats are continuous range and Eastern Ghats are discontinuous range. Because of the rivers, it dissected by the rivers. Nadula nadula inga rivers vandu ipdi pogum. River Krishna, River Godavari, Vaigai, Kaveri, Mahanadi. Adala nadula ipdi poradunala, they are dissected by the rivers. Adanal da anga gap irukku. That is why Eastern Ghats are discontinuous range. Understand? Next we will go to, there are many hills in the Western Ghats, they are Anaimudi, Cardamom Hills, and in the Western Ghats we have many hill stations. Anaimudi is in the Western Ghats, and Kodaikanal, the famous Kodaikanal, Ooty, Kodaikanal. We can say the nine hill stations. This Kodaikanal is in the Cardamom Hills. Understand? The famous Kodaikanal. Kodaikanal solrala nama povomla tour kala povomla Kodaikanal. This Kodaikanal is in the Cardamom Hills. It is in the Western Ghats. Understand? Now, next one. In the Eastern Ghats also we have the some hills, hill resorts we have. This Eastern Ghats and Western Ghats, it meets at a great place that is called as Nilgiris. This place, Nilgiris. Nama Ooty solrala Nilgiris. Nilagiri, in Tamil we will say, you know, that is only Nilgiris. The Western Ghats and the Eastern Ghats, they joined in a place that is called as Nilgiris. Can you able to follow? The Western Ghats are, we continuous up this port kambar. This is hill, hilly region. Abde mala madri we poyite irukom. This is continuous range. Western Ghats are continuous range. Ungalku distinguish between la, they will ask you this question. Distinguish between Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats. At that time you have to write, Western Ghats is continuous range and Eastern Ghats are discontinuous. Inga appadi vittu vittu potrukan baarenga miss, the mountains inga nadula nadula gap potrukan la. Why the Eastern Ghats are discontinuous? Because the rivers, they are dissected the Eastern Ghats. The rivers idu valiya appadi podu poite Bay of Bengal la drain aagum. Endha river sonna Mahanadi, River Mahanadi in Orissa, River Godavari, then River Krishna, River Kaveri, River Vaigai, River Tamaravarani. These rivers, they dissected. Abde Malaya Thandi Kodanjiti enna pannudha? It flow into, it drain into Bay of Bengal. So that is why Eastern Ghats are discontinuous range. Understand children? So 2 marks they will ask you this question. So you have to write this. And the point which joined together Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats, they joined in a place that is called as Nilgiris. Okay. Next we'll go to, there are many rivers in the western side. I told you. What are the rivers? I told you. River Mahanadi. Then River Godavari. The important rivers I am writing. River Krishna, River Kaveri, River Vaigai, and River Tamaravarani, and many, some of the small, small rivers are there. Understand? So these are the rivers which is in the Eastern Ghats. And in Western Ghats there are some rivers. They are Narmada, River Narmada, and River Tapti. They are twin rivers, Tapti. They are in the Western Ghats. So these are all about the peninsula plateau. Now we'll pass on to coastal plains. Next, have you taken down the notes? Ella ezhudhuningla, note la copy panningla? Already before that we told you, you have to buy the books children, then only you can follow the lessons. You can understand the lessons, and whenever you are going seeing that online classes, you should take your book, and along with the book you have one notebook. Each and every subject you should have a notebook. Whatever we are teaching in the board, we are teaching the lessons, we are writing on the board, no, that you have to copy in the notebook, then only you can follow. Have you all copied this? Shall we go to next one? Next division, the fourth division, is the coastal region. Fourth division is coastal region, coastal plains. Coastal plains. Here, this coastal plains, we can divide into two coastal plains are the, they are divided into two coastal plains. They are west coastal plain, west coastal plain, and east coastal plain. West Coastal Plain. There are two divisions in the coastal plains. One is West Coastal Plain and another one is East Coastal Plain. Here, the West Coastal Plain, it starts from, I'll show in the map. You have to draw the map also, children. Roughly, you draw the map. சும்மா ரஃபாக ஒரு மேப் போடுங்க, அப்போ தான் உங்களுக்கு நல்லா இருக்கும், படிக்கிறதுக்கு ஈஸியாக இருக்கும். விஷுவலி யூ கேன் சே, படிக்கும்பொழுதே சைட் பை சைட், இஃப் யூ ட்ரா த மேப் ஒன்லி விஷுவலாக நீங்கள் பார்க்கவும் முடியும், யூ கேன் ரீட் த பாயிண்ட்ஸ் ஆல்சோ. ஸோ த வெஸ்ட் கோஸ்டல் பிளெயின் இஸ் திஸ் சைட் நியர் த சி. கோஸ்ட்னா என்னம்மா, கடலோர பகுதின்னு சொல்கிறோம்ல, தட் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் கோஸ்டல் ரீஜன். அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் த கோஸ்டல் பிளெயின்ஸ். ஸோ த வெஸ்டர்ன் சைடில் இருக்கிறது வெஸ்ட் கோஸ்டல் பிளெயின், தட் இஸ் அரேபியன் சி. அண்ட் த ஈஸ்டர்ன் சைடில் இருக்கிறது தட் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் ஈஸ்ட் கோஸ்டல் பிளெயின் நியர் பே ஆஃப் பெங்கால். திஸ் இஸ் ஈஸ்ட் கோஸ்டல் பிளெயின். சும்மா அப்ரிவேஷன் மட்டும் மிஸ் எழுதுகிறேன், ஏன்னா ஆல்ரெடி ஐ ஹவ் ரிட்டன் ஹியர். திஸ் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் வெஸ்ட் கோஸ்டல் பிளெயின். தெர் ஆர் டூ டிவிஷன் ஆஃப் கோஸ்டல் பிளெயின்ஸ். One by one we'll see then. The West Coastal Plain, it starts from Ran of Kutch. Ran of Kutch. From Ran of Kutch, the West Coastal Plain, it starts until here Kanyakumari. Till Kanyakumari. This is West Coastal Plain. From Ran of Kutch till Kanyakumari. Understand? And this West Coastal Plain, there are some divisions in the West Coastal Plain. Here in the north, it is called as Konkan Plain. Say all of you, Konkan Plain. In the north part of West Coastal Plain is called as Konkan Plain. In the middle part, it is called as Kanara Plain. Karnataka irukudla, adha vandu Kanara Plain. And in the south of the West Coastal Plain, it is called as Malabar. கேரளா நம்ம பார்க்குறோம்ல, மலபார்னா உங்களுக்கு தெரிஞ்சிருக்கணும், இட் இஸ் இன் கேரளா. ஓகே, மலபார், மலபார் பிளெயின். ஸோ த கோஸ்டன் பிளெயின் ஆஃப் வெஸ்டர்ன் கோஸ்டல் பிளெயின் இஸ் டிவைடட் இன்டூ த்ரீ. ஒன் இஸ் கொங்கன் பிளெயின், செகண்ட் ஒன் த மிடில் பார்ட் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் கனரா பிளெயின், அண்ட் த சவுதர்ன் பார்ட் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் மலபார் பிளெயின். அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட்? அண்ட் இந்த ஹியர் லிசன் வெரி கேர்ஃபுல்லி, தேர் ஆர் சம் லாகூன்ஸ் ஆல்சோ, லாகூன்ஸ், பேக் வாட்டர்ஸ். Understand? Small area of Kuvam solrala, like that we have in this coastal area. Ella edathiliyum some lagoons are there. The fresh water lake is also there, and the salt lake is also there, that they are called as the lagoons and the backwaters. We can see in this, and Vembanad is a famous backwaters in this West Coastal Plain. Vembanad is the lake in the West Coastal Plain. Have you understand, children? Konkan Coast in the north, Kanara Coast in the middle, and Malabar Coast in the south. These are about West Coastal Plain. And come to the point, East Coastal Plain. Eastern side la irukkira coast vandu East Coastal Plain, we should say. This Eastern Coastal Plain, it start from West Bengal. Here is West Bengal. It start inge enna paathom, from Ran of Kutch to Kanyakumari. Here in the East Coastal Plain, it starts from West Bengal till Kanyakumari. Understand? So idu endha states la la sendu varudhu appdin paatha, West Bengal, Odisha, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu. East Coastal Plain. West Coastal Plain la endha state la varudhu nu paatha, Gujarat, Maharashtra, Karnataka and Kerala. Understand? Note it down. If you have the book, you can see them. Here, in the East Coastal Plain, there are many alluvial soils are there. Alluvial soils are there. Understand? We can see the alluvial soils here. And this East Coastal Plain in the West Bengal, Odisha, these area is called as Northern Sarkas. Northern Sarkas. இங்கே நம்ம பார்த்தோம்ல, வெஸ்ட்டில் கொங்கன் கோஸ் இதை பார்த்தோம். அதே மாதிரி இதுக்கும் டிவிஷன்ஸ் உண்டு. இந்த டிவிஷனில் நார்த்தில் இருக்கிறது நார்தன் சர்க்காஸ், தமிழ்நாடில் இருக்கிறது தட் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் கோரமாண்டல் கோஸ்ட். கோரமாண்டல் கோஸ்ட்.